Hello, space fans, and welcome to Your Sky Tonight. My name is Tony Darnell from deepastronomy.space. Tonight, we are entering the realm of the fall skies. On September 21st, the nighttime became longer than the daytime, which is great news for those of us looking up and relishing the wonders of the distant universe spinning overhead. The night skies of autumn bring with it many exciting objects as we go out earlier each night to follow the increasing nighttime hours. The Earth moves into an area of its orbit where magnificent constellations come into view. The mighty constellation of Orion, with its untold treasures, are made available to us just after midnight. It contains a huge stellar nursery, the Great Orion Nebula, and is visible with your naked eye on dark nights. The constellation of Taurus the Bull, with the magnificent Pleiades following him on his back, is also available to us. So much is happening in the fall skies that will last well into the darkest winter nights that there will be much to keep us busy. Tonight, I want to focus on one of my favorite night sky objects, the great galaxy of Andromeda. Like the Orion Nebula, you can actually see the Andromeda Galaxy with your naked eye if you're fortunate enough to live under reasonably dark skies. It will appear as a large, faint smudge of light in the northwestern skies. If you're not lucky enough to live under dark skies, then a pair of binoculars will definitely allow you to see it. The way I've always found the Andromeda Galaxy is to first find the constellation Cassiopeia, which looks like a sideways M or a W this time of year. Using the top three stars, which make up a kind of arrowhead, follow it about a hand's width distance to the east and look for a smudge of light. The Andromeda Galaxy is very large in the sky, spanning 3 full degrees in our night sky. If we could see all of the galaxy by making it much brighter, it would span 6 full moons. Because it is so dim, however, we can really only see the center or nucleus of the galaxy with our naked eye. If you're not using binoculars, you may have to be patient and let your eyes completely adapt to the darkness, and then try to use your peripheral vision to see it. The edges of your eyes are more sensitive to black and white than the center, so looking askance really helps. This galaxy is 2.5 million light years away and traveling towards the Milky Way at almost 500,000 kilometers per hour, and will eventually collide with our galaxy in about 4 billion years hence. This means that if we can manage to somehow live long enough, this deep sky naked eye object will only get brighter. Well, that's it for this episode, space fans. Thank you all so much for listening. And as always, keep looking up. Deep Astronomy is sponsored by The Great Courses Plus, a subscription on-demand video learning service where space fans can enjoy lectures in astronomy from top professors from around the world. I particularly recommend Exoplanets, What Astronomers Know by Dr. Joshua Wynn. Go to thegreatcoursesplus.com/deepastronomy to get a free 1-month trial to check out all the great stuff they have. And you can support Deep Astronomy by getting a subscription. I think space fans everywhere will get a lot out of their courses.